Just a quick demo of what I've been working on lately. A while ago I built this kegerator for our homebrew. It also acts as our living room table. It's a chest freezer with a collar and a replacement top. Acts as the table surface. It's got four taps on top. Corny kegs sit inside the freezer. But this is what I've been working on most recently. It's a STM32 microcontroller with a LCD touchscreen, and it controls the temperature inside the kegerator, as well as weighing each keg so we know how much beer we've got left, so we know when to brew. Now you can see the first keg's nearly full. We've got nothing in the middle two kegs, and the fourth keg's got about a pint in it, which is actually sanitizer because I'm cleaning the lines at the moment. So I thought I'd just give a demo of running that out, and hopefully that pint's left will drop to zero. Yep, dropped to zero. There's probably still a little bit left in there, which is why there's a little bit of a blue bar there. But the touchscreen is used for... I can calibrate all of the kegs in here, so calibration works by telling the system when there's an empty keg there, and then when there's a full one on there, you basically tell it before and after a pint, so it knows what exactly a pint weighs. The other thing you can do in here is set the temperature. So at the moment I've got the target temperature set to about 6 degrees, but I can up and down that from here, and it'll maintain that temperature in the bottom of the kegerator, and that's obviously the serving temperature of the beer. Inside the kegerator you can see all the beer and gas lines and insulation to keep the cold in. But the interesting part is down in the bottom, you can see those circles of plywood. They're the pads that the kegs sit on, and underneath each one is a pair of load cells from some cheap bathroom scales. They're all connected to that little black box in the corner. In there is a bunch of instrumentation amplifiers. Now those load cells are actually pretty insensitive. Full deviation with a keg on there is generates about a millivolt, so the gain in that little box and why it's down there close to the load cells instead of up on top is because those amplifiers have a gain of about 2000, so don't want too much noise picked up through long wires to the amplifiers. Anyway, the amplified signal comes out of there and runs up that cable and through the top into the microcontroller where it's sampled by the ADC and converted in from, you know, a voltage measurement into a pint approximation. Around on the side we have this little wooden box which contains the transformer which powers all the electronics, and it's also got a relay in there, and that switches the freezer on and off. And pretty standard on the outside we've got our CO2 cylinder and pressure regulators.